What's up guys, you're watching Tuck TV and welcome back to another episode of VST Thursdays. If this is the first time you're on our channel, give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button along with the bell icon for more updates from us. So as part of this thing that we do called VST Thursdays, we go ahead and check out based on the inputs that you get or what's new in the market. We check out and review VST software, a virtual studio technology software, and see what are some of the amp sims and all of that are available to you as a bedroom jammer, or even if you're looking to track and record. Of course, at the end of the day, a VST is modeled off some sort of an actual physical amp. So many a times you have various amp sims which are available to you in both paid versions as well as free versions. So in today's video, I am going to go ahead and select some particular amp simulations, and I'm going to compare them, you know, the paid versions against their free counterparts to firstly see what are some of the differences and if there is a difference, by how much. So the two simulations I am going to be using, the first one is a simulation of the Friedman BE100. So the free version of that is going to be by Nalex, and that is called the Nalex Crunchman. Absolutely free to use, linked in the description, and you know, you can check that out. I did review a lot of Nalex's stuff already, so in case you haven't seen that video, you can check that out as well. It's linked in the description. And in terms of its paid counterpart, I am going to be using the BE100 amp sim emulation by Brainworks. Now this of course is a bundle. You're going to get two amps with it by default. You get the BE100 and you also get the Dirty Shelly. And this bundle comes to you at a whopping $249. That translates to, as on date when this video was shot, it's roughly about 18,500 rupees, which is a lot. And as you can see over here, in terms of UI, the both of them are pretty straightforward. They're modeled off the BE100, as mentioned, a Friedman amp, and do resemble it, considerably. There are a few things here and there that you might find different. So one thing you will see is that on the Crunchman, which is the free version of it, you got a CFF switch, which is nothing but the C45 switch, which you would get on the BE100. So apart from those basic nomenclature differences, they're pretty much the same. Another set of amps that I'm going to be using are dual rectifiers. So for the free version, again, I'm using Nalex, and the Nalex version is called the Pectifier. As you can see it over here, pretty straightforward, looks like a dual rectifier. And comparing it to a paid counterpart, in this case, I'm going to be using Amplitude 4. And this is the Mesa Boogie dual rectifier that you get. So this comes to you as part of a Mesa Boogie bundle with Amplitude. And that is available to use, comes in at about 150 euros. So again, translated, it's about 13,000 odd rupees, you know, based on the date when this was shot, which again isn't cheap. Having said that, it does come to you with a bunch of amps. You get the dual rectifier, you get the Mark IV, you also get the transatlantic and a bunch of caps that you can go ahead and use. To start things off, first I'm going to be playing a particular riff. You're going to hear the riff as is, first on the free version and then on the paid version, and then we're also going to go ahead and look at it in a mix. And of course, to keep a level playing field, all of it is tuned to high noon, so you're going to see everything tuned bang in the middle. Let's start off with the Friedman. Make sure you're using a good set of speakers or headphones to pick up on finer differences. Oh, one disclaimer, in all of these experiments, I am not using any of the cabinets or the IRs that have come pre-packed with the amp sims. I've gone ahead and turned all of them off, and I'm using an external, cab simulator, and that is the same for all of them. All right, so that was the Friedman, both the Nalix Crunchman as well as the Friedman B100 by BrainWorks. So next up, we're going to look at the rectifiers. And while I was doing this experiment, one weird thing I kind of picked up on is when I was using the Amplitube version of it, tuned bang in the middle, it was weak. And weak is an understatement. I mean, this is what it sounded like. So because it sounded like that, it didn't really make sense to face it off against Nalix's Spectifier. So in this particular case, I did have to go ahead and do a little bit of tuning, and I had to push the knobs a little bit and push the amp to get, you know, Amplitube 4's offering on the same level playing field as the Spectifier. And now that I did, this is what it sounds like, as mentioned, first as is and then in a mix. Alright, so that's that. What are some of the differences? What did you think about it? Let me know in the comments. If I have to give my thoughts, starting off with the Friedman, I personally like the sound of the Crunchman. I mean, considering that that's a free amp, that is an incredibly amazing sound that it produces. On the other hand, the offering by BrainWorks at stock did, have a little roomier tone, but it was fuller, you know, if you really have to listen to it outside of a mix. Obviously, if you tune the knobs a little bit, you will get, you know, a much more richer and finer, fine-tuned sound that you want. And in terms of the dual rectifiers, as mentioned to you, at stock, the dual rectifier was quite weak. But of course, when I went ahead and did, you know, a little bit of tuning, it worked out. So with that, I come to the end of this episode. What did you think about it? What are your thoughts? Free or paid? What direction would you take? Let me know. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to our channel. This is Tuck TV signing off. Until next time, stay metal.